the Pacific Northwest as we get set for football at Lumen Field here in the SoTo District of Seattle. Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup between the Arizona Cardinals and the Seattle Seahawks. Season is upon us. We've got the gift of the NFL as we're underway here in week 16. This taken in at the goal line. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. It's Mostert to start the drive. And they're able to get this one across the 35. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue, just make sure you feed me the football? And that's what they're all about. Continuity, rhythm, number of carries. Just keep giving it to him.
On first down, they go with Mostert again. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39. These two teams, they met up in Seattle earlier in the year with the Seahawks coming away victorious. So a win here in Seattle, tough as that may be, would give them the season sweep. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Now Murray. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And they bring this one back. It's a fumble recovery and a Seattle touchdown. And Charles, look at the big fella. What a rumble that was. Not only to scoop it, but then take it the rest of the way for the touchdown.
And now you know they're going to have to hear about it from now on. The defensive backs, he's going to want to run with them, do their drills, the whole deal. He thinks he's the pace setter now.
It doesn't matter what happens in practice this week, he's smiling. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. On the return, Rondale Moore will bring it out. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped it to 23. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They'll start on the ground with Mostert. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
On second and 11 now, Murray got his man, Robbie Anderson. The 30, 10, touchdown, Cardinals. Well, go ahead and strap in, partner. Less than 2 minutes in, had the score on the one side. A quick answer, though, to get the equalizer.
Sometimes you get that sense of urgency that ratchets up, right? When you give up an early touchdown like that, you just know you're like, okay, how do we go back and equalize things? Can we get it done fast? And they absolutely did. Essentially, we're back to even, aren't we?
Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Play action. Now Wilson. Sideline throw. It's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. So 5 yards here, five on the play, and it's second down. And now some motion before the snap. And this will be our first penalty of the night's proceedings. The false start penalty, and now they're back to needing 10 yards on second down. Here's Wilson. And that is incomplete.
I love those corners who can not only cover, but don't mind getting a little physical as well. How about the coverage on that play, knocking that pass away?
Complete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and 10. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Open man, that's Noah Fant, the tight end. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And a nice milestone reached on that last throw as here late in the season, he goes over 4,000 yards passing.
And he's really thrown the ball well all season long, had some big games along the way. He's inspired his receiving corps to go out and make plays for him in each and every ball game.
Wilson's throw into the hands of Fant. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
That was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 47. They'll run. It's Kenneth Walker. And great blocking downfield as he's got this almost to the 35-yard line. Same exact result as last play, a pickup of 11.
Some big plays in the passing game on this drive. And here's one out of the running game. So the passing game loosening things up. Now there's room to roam.
Now Wilson on first down. This is the tight end Fant, and he's brought down here just outside of the 20. Well, that's not just his first, not his second, already his third completion here on the opening drive, and I think it's safe to say that getting him the ball in this game, one of their top priorities.
And a top priority for the defense has got to be finding ways to cover him, and I don't think you can have one basic coverage to get it done. You have to throw a number of coverages at him, make him think as he's running downfield, and hope you can create a little bit of havoc.
Second and 7 with our score tied at 7, but they're planning to change that soon. Only question, will they get 3 or 6 out of it? Play action. It's Wilson. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
An 8-play drive to this point. So here's play number 9 on 3rd and 7. Now it's Wilson. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Looks like a 9-yard loss. And it also brings up 4th.
Well, it's about how teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal, that's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know he hated taking the loss there on third down. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially. So a net gain of one there. Drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. Well, this drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. In Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone, and there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Murray gonna throw, sliding out of the pocket. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins, and they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. First catch of the game for Hopkins. It's a first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse, still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
First down, Murray. He'll get this complete to Rondale Moore. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. So 8 yards on the completion there, and it'll be second in a couple.
Well, this defense for the Seahawks, they were excellent a week ago in the win over Pittsburgh.
And what I saw on film was a nearly unstoppable pass rush. 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries given up.
Cardinal football here to start quarter number two. Only needing 2 yards on second down. On second down, Mostert. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down.
I think we call that season's greetings right there. He came up, pow, knocked him for a loss.
Throwing now is Murray. And that is incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
Blake Gillikin on to punt now on fourth down.
Back deep for the Seahawks, Tyler Lockett. He gets this away. It's a good one, drawing toward the sidelines. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for three.
But you gotta like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blows, the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side,
maybe a little gas.
Yeah,
right?
A little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting off field only giving up three. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
Loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. Throw out wide to Walker. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. It's a gain of 15. First down, Seahawks.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. As long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Lock it in motion right. Walker now on first and 10. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. The Seahawks at 11-3 on the year. And they've certainly found their groove of late. Winners of 5 in a row.
And this team is absolutely playing their best football right now. This is the best that we've seen them play in a long time, partner. Sky's the limit as far as they're concerned. Their confidence really soaring.
Second and a yard. Wilson. That's complete to DK Metcalf. And he's tackled at the 38, but they doubled their yardage. The play started at the 19, and they gained 19.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Running right, here's Walker. And he'll get it inside the 35.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Here's Wilson. And the catch is made here by Tyler Lockett. And they'll work this down inside the 30.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys that we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. The slot man in motion right. They'll try for the first with Walker. And he's able to motor his way down to the 16-yard line. That one good for 14 and a Seahawk first.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. He's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. I always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. Throwing is Wilson. And this is going to be intercepted. Buda Baker with a pick. And the Cardinals are going to have the football at their own 1-yard line. The defense looked geared up to stop the run, but obviously, Charles, they were ready for the pass, too.
Yeah, they were hoping they could catch everyone crashing and playing the run, but that was a very ill-advised throw right there. The opportunity lost.
Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. But the good news for them, they got the football. The bad news, they have to go 99 yards here as they start this drive out on their own 1-yard line. Meanwhile, Murray's throw here into the hands of Moore. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's 2nd down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
To throw again on 2nd down. Murray trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. So this defense doubling its pleasure there. Remember, they had the fumble return for a score earlier in the game, and now this time an interception return for another score. The call is to go for 1 and kick the extra point. It's good to make it 17-7. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. From deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. To go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
Play action. Now it's Murray. He's got the connection to Moore. A little juke. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33. That was so well timed. Just a perfect throw on the slant.
Hit him on the move, didn't he? Now he's going against the grain of the defenders coming over to try and stop him. That allowed for that additional yardage downfield.
So how about this for a change in field position? From inside the 10, here's first down on the other side of the field. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. The defense showing some anger after giving up the big play. This time they'll lose one or two.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Murray now to throw. Finding his target, it's Trey McBride. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run. 30 yards. So we are at halftime here on Christmas Eve as we send you cross-country to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. The Seahawks with the advantage, and they get the football first as the second half is underway. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. They're unable to connect, but a late flag comes in. And the contact may have come too early. Well, there were about 70,000 that were quickly calling for that flag. It comes out there for pass interference.
And what do you think, partner? A little sarcasm in that cheering from this crowd here tonight. What they're hoping now is to build a little momentum off of it and give them a more genuine reason to cheer down the road.
They go play action now. Wilson. Pass is caught. It's Metcalf going across the field here. And they're going to get this up to midfield.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Here we go.
They go play action with Wilson. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And this will be caught by Metcalf for a Seahawk touchdown. Quite a show of arm strength right there. That was in the air for a long time, and it was on target, too. Now for the point after. And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17. The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field, and we are ready to rock. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. Driving at the line, the Cardinal offense. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. To throw, it's Murray. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. And the Seahawks are going to take possession of the football. Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores, but yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
After the interception, here's Wilson throwing the out route, and he connects with Fan. And he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. They'll get 34 yards there. And worth pointing out, after that last completion, that puts this young quarterback over 10,000 yards passing for his career. And fair to say, he's not done yet.
No doubt about it. He's really just getting started because he's not quite into the prime of his career. So it's likely he's going to hit a few more of these milestones as this career progresses. So let's face it, we'll acknowledge this number and we'll celebrate the milestones down the road.
From the gun, it's Wilson. And it's caught. And he gets halfway there from the four to the two on a gain of two. From the two now, second and goal. To throw is Wilson. And he fires one that's intercepted. Buda Baker with a pick. And the Cards are going to take possession here at their own 3-yard line. The one side gets an interception, but their defense comes on the field and picks them right back up by getting a pick of their own.
And I think you saw the same thing that I did, Brandon. As he ran off the field after making that play, we saw his quarterback seek him out and offer a personal thank you to bail him out a little bit as the offense takes the field again.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They take over here following the interception. That's the good news. The tough spot is the spot that they're in. That's inside the five in the shadow of their own goalpost here, first and 10. And they work this out past the 25. That one goes for 24 yards.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent,
and sometimes spectacular.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Here's Murray. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. And the Seahawks are going to take over at their own 30-yard line. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are in December. Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. He's going to float this one deep right side. And intercepted, Wilson's third of the game. Jalen Thompson picks it, and the Cardinals are going to have the football here at their own 35-yard line. Well, that one was in the air for an agonizingly long time.
Just begging to be picked off, wasn't it? It's one thing if you're throwing a ball like that, trying to throw someone open or lead them into an area. But that ball needed to be thrown with a lot more conviction. As a result, it's an easy interception.
Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their 35-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And Murray in trouble here, and down he goes. Rashawn Gary in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
If we go back to the last series, remember, their coverage allowed them to get a turnover in the last drive, a takeaway, and that helped contribute to a sack on this one. I think maybe this quarterback's a little bit hesitant. Last time he turned it over, now he sees his zone coverage, a little bit slow to get rid of the football.
And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. First target, first catch at a first down. Now Murray. And the Seahawks defense gets to him and they bring him down. A well-designed corner blitz that gets him for a loss of 8 yards.
Well, someone is certainly having a big game, and while that sack doesn't quite have the splash of his pick six from earlier, you know he's thrilled to be making big plays during a great individual effort today.
Throwing on second and long, Murray. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an... Oh, they try a lateral on the return, and now the ball's loose. Well, do you want to unpack that one, or do you want me to?
You're the boss.
We get the interception, then really he's just too loose with the football on the return, and he coughs it right back up the other way.
I've seen this happen in an NFL game, and boy, did it cost someone. San Francisco at Atlanta a few seasons ago. Atlanta throws the interception. San Francisco runs it back. Game is salted away. Fumbles on the return. Atlanta gets it back, drives down, kicks the game-winning field goal.
About that, and a crazy situation we just saw there. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
And there's another stop. One of the league's best defenses is certainly bringing it again this week.
Third quarter action, and we appreciate you spending your Christmas Eve right here with us. Second and 10. Murray now. Over the middle, complete. That's Anderson. And they're going to get this down to about the 37. Third and 2, and here's Murray. They'll get this into the hands of Mostert. And he is going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Murray going to throw. He'll hit Mostert again here. Touchdown, Cardinals! Raheem Mostert, touchdown number 15 of the year. And the Cardinals have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth.
Fairbairn good with the extra point. And the lead down to 10, 24-14. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. Well, don't look now, but they've got a little bit of a battle on their hands again. Back to a two-score game, the interception that led to a touchdown. You'd have to think they're a little more careful here if they do indeed try to throw the football.
Yeah, and I was a little surprised by the last throw. You know, that type of throw in this type of a game, I would be very careful about it. Maybe the only throw you make is maybe a toss to your halfback or something like that. Otherwise, take care of the thing and finish this bad boy off.
Now it's second and nine. Sticking with Walker on second down.
And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a third and nine situation. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score, but they can't be so aggressive as to give up their edge, their gaps, and have the offense hit them with a...
And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need.
Isaiah Simmons picking it off. And the Cards are going to take possession of the football.
That is the play they needed in a two-score game here in the fourth quarter.
No doubt about it. They did what they had to do to give themselves a chance to get back into the game. They turned it over to the offense. They are now in charge.
Now they need to execute. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. After the turnover, here's Murray. Pressure comes, he's taken down by the Seahawk defense. Rashawn Gary, his second sack of the night.
I think we're both starting to run out of adjectives because this pressure has been relentless all game, but none of the prior sacks might be as impressive as the one we just saw.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Going quickly out wide to Moore. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. Give him a gain of five on the completion. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here.
When you call a wide receiver screen, no matter how many blockers you get in front of the guy that catches the ball, there's still an aspect of the guy catching it, turning into a runner, breaking tackles and creating his own yardage, and he just did on that play.
Found his target, it's Anderson. Touchdown, Cardinals! Robbie Anderson with his second touchdown of the night. And the Cardinals have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter.
So just a three-point game now as they send this one away. And a couple yards deep, he'll go to a knee. He won't return it. And they'll take it out to the 25. To the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And with that last touchdown, I mean, we're set up for a good finish here. Some things to consider, Charles. Obviously, it's a very close game here in the fourth quarter. Defensively, they've got all three timeouts in their back pocket.
So the chess match really ramps up, doesn't it? Because in these situations, what do you do? Do you run the ball and kill the clock here? Or do you try and bury them with another score? And how about defensively? Do you use your timeouts as early as opportunity? Or wait till you hit the two-minute warning? So there's a lot going into this one. Let's see how each side goes about their strategy.
Back to Walker on first down. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
I think as a running back in this spot, you have to understand there's not going to be a whole lot of room to run. And in this case, ball protection takes precedent over trying to make something happen.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Now Wilson. Over the middle, that's caught by Metcalf. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals 35. That one good for 16 as the drive continues. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it. They got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
On the counter, it's Walker, and he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down. Now, the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
The last run got a couple here, second and 8. They run again with Walker. And not much running room. Down to the 32. They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
The 25-yard line is what they need here. This is third down. Play action. Now Wilson. He's got his tight end fan. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. Less than 2 to play with just a field goal separating these two sides. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Up the middle, here's Walker. 80 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's going on.
This defense needs a big play in the worst way because so far, they're not putting up much of a fight. If they don't get a stop here soon, this game could be over for them.
It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Here's Walker. And he's going to pull his way down to about the 1 yard line. It's a good pickup of 7 yards, and now they're looking at second and goal.
That's a great run right there on first down. Didn't quite get into the end zone, but now you've set yourself up for at least 2, maybe 3 more shots from close range.
Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Another yard would probably put this thing in the books. It's second and one. Here's the sneak with Wilson. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it. And that touchdown, Charles, with very little time remaining, boy, it just sucked any energy and momentum out of the other sideline.
Yeah, take an incredible comeback in the final minute to bring this one back to even. A great series there offensively. It's all an opportunity to slam the window shut, and they follow through.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They can't do much at this point, partner. This one is going to go down in the loss column.
You don't make up for what has happened during the game.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Quadre Diggs. And the Seahawks are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield. Charles, are you kidding me? Four interceptions? I mean, that's a good season for a lot of defensive backs.
A lot of reason to get voted into the Pro Bowl. When you have four in one game, that means, talk about a campaign slogan, right? I got four. Send me to the Pro Bowl, guys. What a game we've experienced watching this one.
Defense still with three timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them here as the kneel down comes. So the victory here for Seattle, and it's going to be their defense that gets the ink in the headlines tomorrow, and for good reason. They forced five turnovers in this game.
And while we were watching this game unfold, I kept thinking about when we did our training camp tour and something that you noticed along the way. Just about every camp we visited, when the defense got together, everyone was doing ball drills. Defensive linemen, linebacker, secondary, because they understood how vital it was to take the football away. And they wanted every opportunity. When the ball was knocked free, they want all those guys to be familiar with touching the ball so they can pick up the fumble or get the interception. And we saw it pay off in this one here.
Yeah, five times. He'll remember this one. So for the Seahawks, the wins keep coming as this one moves them to 12-3 on the year.
And they'll get to stay home again next week as Washington comes to town.
Meanwhile, for the Cardinals, it's a tough blow to their playoff aspirations as they drop to 9-6. And they'll try to get back on the beam next week as they'll head to Tampa to take on the Bucs.